I'll be down at the beach. Ah, time for a hiatus filled with rest and relaxation. Is it okay if I crash with you and Grammy for a bit? After a servant made of reanimated clay who identifies as his son appeared on his doorstep, Lucian's afterlife has turned upside down. Gone were the days of slumming it at his mother's beach house without care or responsibility. Now this ghoul must readjust to a new existence of domestic bliss as a single father while suffering through this afterlife in the spectral realm.
Close, you're liable to melt.
Father, do we have any more long pork rinds? I'm starving.
No, you and that black hole you call a stomach have devoured nearly all the food in the house.
Well, you have to go grocery shopping, Father. Grammy hasn't been here to...
That's enough out of you, young man. Don't you have some tinkering to do?
Yes, I'm actually almost finished with this new...
Who, my devil? It's almost October.
It is? You mean...
I must be off to the mortal realm at once.
It's Spookhouse time.
Not for you, underling.
But, Father, you promised I could return this year.
No, Number One, I didn't promise. I lied. Now, with Mother having gone and run off with that Kevin imbecile, you're the man of the house, unfortunately, so don't burn the place down.
But, Father, how are you?
See you in a few months. Toodles.
Father, how are you going to run the spook house this year without any help? And I didn't even get to show you this year's plot device yet. Oh, I just have to get to the mortal realm to help you, but how? I know! Oh, Mother Bethesda, please perceive my pagan plea and to the mortal realm send me! Oh, look! She's astral projecting! How cool is that?
What do you want, you little brat? I'm busy.
Dear Mother Bethesda, I need your assistance in returning to the mortal realm. I am needed at the spook house, and I haven't the life essence remaining to get back there on my own.
You better make it worth my while.
I'm prepared to make the ultimate sacrifice.
The spook house without all of you here, my precious servant golems. Oh, look at you, so full of light, snails, and puppy dog tails. Alone again. I'm unsure how I'm going to manage the cinema this year without any extra eccentric help, but I think I can do it. Yeah, I'll power through with my usual grit, determination, blind stubbornness and misplaced confidence. I'll do it for you, my dear servant golems. Yes, the Spookhouse shall go on as planned, even if I have to run the whole show myself, and let's face it, I'd actually prefer that.
No, Father! You are not alone!
It cannot be!
Hello, Number One! How on this earth did you get to this earth, and all of your glowiness has...
I have come to help you, Father. See, I struck a bargain with Mother Bethesda. She crafted a spell which allowed me to return to the mortal realm where I was created, but I had to sacrifice something in return. I gave up my life essence, so technically I am...
You're dead?
Yes, I...
That's wonderful!
Yes, I am a poltergeist like yourself, but I think I'm still made out of clay, maybe, kind of, I don't know, who cares?
Not me! And remind me to send a thank you note to Bethesda the Witch, but, you know, like, written in blood, so it's still mildly threatening.
I needed to be here for you and the Spookhouse.
You are producing the show, I hope you realize, not after.
No, 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 my revolutionary days are far behind me. I am not here to sow dissent, Father. I even chose this more utilitarian outfit to properly convey my new demoted status.
I know how my departed Golem brethren operated behind the scenes here at the Spookhouse.
And now, for Golem Number One is prepared to take their burden upon his shoulders and carry out their duty with pride. It is the least I could do to honor their memory and atone for my past mistakes.
Well, I must say, Number One, I have a deep admiration for your new sense of duty. You're hired.
Hell yes!
I suppose our first order of business shall be finding a new producer. What say we get into a lengthy interview montage where we sit down with a series of wacky new side characters filled with sight gags and horror movie theme shenanigans where we inevitably settle upon a candidate that's poorly suited for the position and will surely cause trouble for the show in later episodes.
Don't you think we are running a bit long on time as it is?
Yes, I suppose you're right.
Plus, I have an idea for our next producer.
Oh, you do?
Yes, but it can wait until we get to the frightful features.
Ah, that's a smashing idea. I just love those.
You love what?
Cliffhanger endings. Be seeing you soon, Spookies and Spookettes! Even something to get excited about? I don't know, but
you should be excited to hold all that power! The power to have your voice be heard over the screeching howls of the damned that inhabit this haunted place!
But don't you let that power I'll get to your weak human mind as I'll steal the ghoul in charge here. Well, until November rears its thankful head at least, but anyway, we'll get to the trailers for your catastrophic choices in a moment, but first, Lucien would like to make an introduction. Yes, sir. Someone very special is here to help this old ghoul out with his spooky movie show, so without further ado, my spookies and spookettes, all the way from the Spectral Realm, the last of his kind, and technically my son, I give you Servant Gollum Number One!
Hi folks, I'm actually here voluntarily, so...
Oh, of course, right, my apologies. Selfless volunteer Gollum Number One!
Thank you, Father! Hi, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Alpha Gollum Number One here to do the odd-job production assistant work that was normally taken care of by my poor departed brethren.
Oh, may the devil rest their souls!
Yes, and I also have an announcement to make.
Yes, Number One was telling me that he had formed some kind of a scheme, harebrained most likely, that would help solve our problem. Our problem being that we are without a producer again.
Indeed, you see, during our hiatus in between Halloween seasons in the Spectral Realm, I came up with an idea that would help solve such a problem should it arise. I made a device!
You made that?
Well, Papa Kevin helped out a little bit, but, I invented it. It's sort of like an automatic instant producer, see?
What the hell?
It is a fully artificial intelligence capable of providing quality horror movie-themed entertainment.
This is outstanding, Number One.
Oh, I know.
Wait a second, is it just me or does it resemble me?
Correct, I based its image off of you when you were alive, and its core reasoning functions are based on your metaphysical intelligence patterns I harvested from your ectoplasm while you slept.
I'm sorry, what?
Let's not get into that too deeply, it's very complicated.
Fair enough. I must say, Number One, I was not expecting such an incredible solution to our problem. This thing really speaks to my, it speaks to my...
Your raging narcissism.
All right, don't get cute, Number One. Just wake up your f***ing science project already.
Activating now.
Activation complete. All systems functional.
This is so exciting.
How may I assist you, Master Lucien?
Oh, Number One, you are a genius. So, what do I do? Just... talk to it?
Yes, Father! It is that simple!
Repeat inquiry! How may I assist you, Master Lucien?
Right. your master! Order you! Hologram producer... Wait, what do I call you?
My operating system is designated Holographic Automaton Program for Producing Entertainment. But a...
H-A-P-P-E... Happy?
Happy!
Ooh, I like that!
That's it! It's perfect! So, shall we call you Happy?
I mean, sure, I guess, if you must.
Happy it is! So, Happy, I trust you have everything under control over there.
I am fully autonomous and require no outside assistance. I began my producing duties the moment I was activated.
He's very efficient.
Then let us continue on with the demonocratic vote.
Commencing trailer playback in 3, 2, 1.
Whoa, hang on a sec, Happy. You have to allow me to remind these dear flesh clods how the vote works.
My sincerest apologies, dear flesh clods.
And now, my petrified patrons, listen carefully. We are about to reveal the 3 movies you have to choose from. We'll watch each terrifying trailer together. And if you haven't gone mad with pure fright, please go down to the comments below and let us know which one of these fine, fearsome features you'd like to see take the October slot of Video with a Vengeance.
So turn your lights down low and say your prayers, for the time is nigh, for choice the first, a film to quench your bloodthirst. From 1979, it's tourist.
Every year, hundreds of young people travel the country and disappear. God help those who get caught in the tourist trap. Tourist Trap, where beautiful young people looking for excitement are tricked, terrorized, trapped. Shock you can see.
No, no.
Terror you can feel. Heart-stopping suspense that makes this the nightmare that never ends. Something crazy is going on at the tourist trap.
What just went wrong?
Oh, oh, me. I know.
Can anyone else tell me?
Trailer playback was 100% functional. No errors detected.
Happy, you cut away to the trailer too soon and you completely botched my introduction. Number one, did you forget to program basic professionalism into this bucket of bolts?
Give him a break, Father. It is his first day.
It is. I shall perform an update upon next shutdown cycle and look into, quote, term, professionalism.
See, he's trying.
You're lucky I like you. Anyway, that was Tourist Trap. Just your average movie about murderous telekinetically animated mannequins. No big whoop, right?
Moving on to choice number two.
Here to unnerve you. From 1992,
the deliciously monikered
John Saxon, star of Death House and Nightmare on Elm Street, stars in Hellmaster. Terror looms at a cryptic college campus when a genius professor, presumed killed in a research experiment, returns to his alma mater for revenge.
People say they used experimental drugs on the students to develop their minds back then.
This madman performs unspeakable experiments with a mutating drug.
Hey, mister. Are you playing with me?
And lets loose his followers to take over the campus.
There's enough of that stuff down there to breed armies of those things.
If a god created this world in 6 days, and I can make hell of it in one night, then God must be dead.
And one gifted student, Shelley O'Dean, is forced to battle the professor in a mental struggle for freedom. Who will emerge victorious? The student or the crazed biochemist? John Saxon as Hellmaster.
Tell me, what do you see?
Oh, poor old Hellmaster. A movie film primarily inside of an active mental institution. And frankly, I cannot wait to see how many of you out there are insane enough to vote for it.
Inquiry, Master, is it not insulting to insinuate that the flesh clod suffer from abnormal mental dispositions?
Hey, how about you toss in a basic understanding of what a joke is packed with your professionalism update? Number one, are you certain Zordon over here is firing on all cylinders?
He have a point, you know.
Oh, hush. Oh, my petrified patrons, we creep closer towards our catastrophic conclusion. Here now, with terror incurred, is Choice the Third from 1983. It's Mausoleum!
Was it a broken dream? An unfinished memory? What terrible secret drew Susan to the mausoleum?
I didn't mean to scare you, Mrs. Farrow.
She gave her soul to the evil force in the mausoleum.
What's the matter, Susan?
What in God's name is...
Oh, my God!
Now, the secret haunts her, and she cannot control the power.
There's some strange shit going on in this house.
What are you talking about? What's wrong with my wife?
She's not your wife. The woman you're living with looks like Susan. She looks exactly like your wife, but she's not your wife.
She lives in horror as she tries to escape the demon she has become.
Obviously, we're not going to be able to confine her. What do you suggest?
Go to the mausoleum tonight.
A new dimension in fright. An experience of untold terror.
This is evil! I am going to finish what your father died trying to do!
Are you brave enough to enter the mausoleum?
Oh, I do hope that one possessed you with the spirit of demonocracy! Yes, and which one of our malicious motion pictures shall you choose from? Will it be Tourist Trap? Hail, Master! Or Mausoleum? The choice is yours and yours alone. Do be kind and leave your vote in the comments below, and we'll have Happy perform some kind of computerized mumbo-jumbo and have the results ready before the next Video with a Vengeance screening on September 25th of some Graydon Clark insanity called Star Games. And this is just the beginning of a fresh new Halloween season here at the Spookhouse Cinema. We have many more frightful things to share with you yet that may send you into a petrifying state of pure, unbridled... Pure, unbridled... Happy, what's another synonym for scary I haven't used yet?
Calculating.
Request located.
Confound. Trepidation.
Sure, I'll take it. Way to go, Happy.
Thank you, Master.
A petrifying state of pure, unbridled trepidation. So stay tuned. We'll be seeing you soon. Until next time.
And don't forget to vote.
Oh, what the hell? Number one, bow. We've discussed this.
No, I'm sorry.
again to the Spookhouse Cinema. I'm Lucien T. Ghoul, and your cataclysmic compare during these peculiar proceedings, these ominous sufferings known to those who dare seek such profane and esoteric knowledge as the frightful features of the Halloween season. We at the Spookhouse are pleased to announce the very first fearsome film to grace our sinister screen this merciless month of October from 1990.
Excuse me, Master, but you appear to be receiving a transmission.
I'm sorry, Happy. What? I can't hear you over this horrible noise. What is this?
There is a transmission attempting to come through on the Phantophone.
A Phantos? A what now?
The Phantophone! A telecommunications device of my own invention that permits real-time transmissions between the mortal and the spectral realms for the very first time.
Wow, you have astonished me yet again, Number One.
Thank you, Father. You see, Phantophone is a portmanteau of Phantom and Fool.
Yeah, I don't care. So, let's see who's calling, huh?
My caller identification system shows it is your mother on the other
My
line.
Mother, Happy, do not dare pick up that phone.
Answer it. Is this working? Am I coming through okay?
Hello, Mother.
Oh, hello, Lucy.
Oh, dear.
You are coming in clearly now. Isn't this contraption marvelous?
Oh, Grammy!
Oh, and there is my genius grandson of mine. How's my little onesie poo?
I'm fine, Grammy. I love you.
Oh, and I love you too, darling. Oh, what have we here? You must be that holographic automaton program for producing entertainment, doohickey, that onesie-boo here built in our old tool shed.
Yes, madam. But I have been given the acronymical sobriquet of Happy completely against my will.
How adorable. The machine thinks it has a will of its own.
You would be surprised. We are quite finished with these pleasantries. Mother, what on this earth are you doing interrupting one of my tapings?
Oh, yes, you see, Lucy, your stepfather and I...
Do not speak of that incubus on my program.
Mind your manners, Lucy.
Oh, don't bother Kevin, I said hi.
Why don't you tell him yourself, onesie-poo? I think he's around here somewhere doing yard work and... Oh, there he is. Hello, darling.
Hi, Papa Kevin, I love you.
Oh, for Pete's sake.
Anywho, Lucy, your stepfather and I were discussing how nice it would be if you showed more family-oriented motion pictures on your little spook house show instead of the usual violent, gore-soaked fare that is normally forced upon the humans.
Absolutely not, Mother.
Don't worry, they are movies that still fit into the theme of your Halloween season. Kevin and I went ahead and spoke with that bookhouse mortal known as Holly and requested both 2009's lovely Coraline and that splendid Paranorman from 2012.
But...
No buts, mister, and don't you try to weasel out of this either, because I am putting my foot down. It is time the Spookhouse opened its doors to humans of all ages.
I think that is a great idea.
Thank you, my lovely grandson. And thank you, everyone out there in the audience, for putting up with my Lucy all these years. I know we can get on the sour side. It's lovely to finally meet you all. You're not the grotesque clods of flesh he's made you out to be.
If that is all, Mother.
Yes, I must be off now. Toodles! Oh, Kevin, darling, it's time for my massage!
Bye-bye, Grammy! Well, that was a lovely visit.
Girl, she is a miserable old crone.
I concur.
Hey! Interrupting my show, interfering with my programming. I mean, can you believe the nerve?
I cannot. Hey, can we just...
The vampiric witch just sucks out all of my enthusiasm without fail.
No, that is enough. That is my grandmother, your very own mother you are speaking so crudely about. She is a strong and sweet old woman who deserves, nay, demands the utmost respect.
No, you're right.
be ashamed!
I am!
It's just that awful Kevin. He's the problem. That incubus has ruined everything.
Papa Kevin is a good man.
You appear to be exhibiting signs of jealousy.
Hey, shut up!
I have a lot of issues I have to work out and solve, so can we just go ahead and
just play the damn trailers already?
Yes, thank you, Happy.
Jeez, I'm going through a whole roller coaster of emotions over here.
Coraline Jones always dreamed of finding a better world. A world more exciting than this. But never did she imagine that she'd discover it in her own home.
We've been waiting for you, Coraline.
Where parents are always fun.
I love your garden!
Can't believe you did this!
And everything is so good.
What's shaking, baby?
It just can't be real.
Mom? You're just in time for supper, dear.
You're not my mother. My mother doesn't have...
Buttons? Do you like them? I'm your other mother, silly.
You probably think this world is a dream come true.
My name!
But you're wrong.
You do like it here, don't you, Coraline? You could stay here forever. There's one tiny little thing we need to do. Black is traditional.
She's got this whole world where everything's better, but it's all a trap.
You may come out when you've learned to be a loving daughter.
From Henry Selick, the director of The Nightmare Before Christmas, comes a world of extraordinary imagination. Spooky secrets.
Who are you? You're in terrible danger, girl.
And daring discoveries.
I still have to find my parents to set them free.
This year, when adventure comes knocking,
choo-choo.
There are some doors that should never be opened.
I'm not scared!
Ah! Coraline, written for the screen and directed by Henry Selick. Meet Norman.
Can't you be like other kids your age?
His parents don't get him.
He's probably up there fiddling with his Ouija or his orb.
Harry.
His sister doesn't like him.
You are such a loser.
And the kids at school.
Look, it's abnormal.
Always pick on him. But he does have some friends.
Norman, wait up.
I like to be alone.
So do I. Let's do it together.
It's just that most of them...
Good morning.
...aren't exactly alive.
How's it hanging?
Haven't heard that one before.
Do you see ghosts, like, all the time? Who's a good boy?
That's not his chin.
Couldn't you use another stall?
Time is running out.
From the makers of Coraline.
The witch's ghost is going to wake up tonight. And when she does, she'll raise the dead.
You've got to use your gift of talking to the dead
to stop it.
This is crazy.
Do I look crazy to you?
You might want to give that a few minutes.
Now, to save his town, he'll need a little help.
Oh, yeah.
I got you.
Oh, this is getting completely out of hand!
Is he dead or what?
And a whole lot of guts.
Is everyone all right? Nobody got bitten?
I bit. I hung. Did that count?
This summer, you don't become a hero.
Norman!
Norman? This is so Norman.
By being normal.
There's no
nothing wrong with being scared, Norman. As long as you don't let it change who you are.
Paranorman.
You wanna play some hockey?
My jewels.
However, there is a special instance of this celebration of the obsolete and mediocre that happens once a year, the Halloween edition, and we here at the Spookhouse are with you this evening to reveal which frightful feature won our latest demonocratic vote, the winner of which shall grace the sinister screen the month of October on Vivid VHS. Now, number one, is our esteemed producer activated?
He is awoken!
All systems functional and ready to serve you, Master.
Excellent. Happy, if you would be so kind as to remind the humans what their choices were.
Yes, Master. Listen carefully, Flash Claws, as I reacquaint you with the candidates for this Halloween season's demonocratic vote. Tourist Trap, Hell Master,
and Mausoleum. Yes, indeed. Now, let's keep this monstrous momentum going and get straight to the announcement of the winner of your next Video with a Vengeance screening. Drum roll, please.
Threat detected. Intruder alert.
Wait, how do we know that's Blob Creek?
Initiate defense mode. Threat eliminated.
What did you do?
What you programmed me to do, Creator.
What have I done?
That was awesome! I mean, wow! Did you see that? Oh, Happy, you really are the greatest producer in Spookhouse history!
Thank you, Master.
But he killed Blob Creature!
Oh, don't be so sappy, Number One. Blob Creature's fine. Remember, he is...
was a sentient, amorphous glob of snot, so I'm sure he'll reconstitute himself eventually, if we should be so unlucky. Initial scan analysis showed subject Blob Creature to be constructed not out of mucus, as you so hypothesized, but primarily out of stray, discarded ectoplasmic waste.
Ew, well, that explains why he always slept in the jar.
That's disgusting and depressing.
Indeed it is. Well, Happy, seeing as how you laser-blasted my drum accompaniment into jello,
how about you do the honors and just announce our damn winner already?
With pleasure, Master. And the winner of this year's demonocratic vote is... pause for dramatic effect. Mausoleum!
Was it a broken dream? An unfinished memory? What terrible secret drew Susan to the mausoleum?
I didn't mean to scare you, Mrs. Farrow.
She gave her soul to the evil force in the mausoleum.
What's the matter, Susan?
Crook's name is...
Oh, my God!
Now, the secret haunts her, and she cannot control the power.
There's some strange shit going on in this house.
What are you talking about? What's wrong with my wife?
She's not your wife. The woman you're living with looks like Susan. She looks exactly like your wife, but she's not your wife.
She lives in horror as she tries to escape the demon she has become.
Obviously, we're not going to be able to confine her. What do you suggest?
Go to the mausoleum tonight.
A new dimension in fright, an experience of untold terror.
This is evil! I am going to finish what your father died trying to do!
Are you brave enough to enter the mausoleum?
Skin at the very thought of our next video with a vengeance Halloween edition. I'm sure it will scare the living daylights out of your quivering human souls. So join old Lucien right here in his dastardly domain as we screen our winner, Mausoleum, later on in the month of October. Date to be determined. Well, we have such sights and frights left to share with you yet at the Spookhouse Cinema, my spookies and spookettes. So stay tuned. I'll be seeing you very soon. Until next time. Oh, look, see, I told you. Hey, quit sleeping in the toilet, you weirdo.
Child who no longer wants money to make any of his favorite
favorite minced goblin pie.
Oh, no, Mother, please. I didn't mean it. I'm under an awful lot of stress right now, and I do love goblin minced pie.
And what is going on?
I will let this interference slide just this once.
Who are you even talking to?
Oh, once a mummy's boy, always a mummy's boy. He's been like that for centuries.
It all began in this little shop.
Ow! Damn roses!
Where, strange as it seems, something extraordinary happened.
I'm afraid it isn't feeling very well today.
No, it's not this one.
What kind of a weirdo plant does that seem?
Little Shop of Horrors, a story about a boy.
I've given you sunlight, I've given you rain. Looks like you're not happy, bless I open a vein.
A girl.
You don't make a nice voice when you live on Skid Row, Mr. Mushnick. See, now this is my date, my boyfriend.
A florist.
I'm telling you, Audrey, he's not a good, clean kind of boy.
He's a professional.
You'll be a dentist. You have a talent for causing pain. Hey, stop me a dentist.
I've been saving all month for this. I think I need a root canal. I'm sure I need a long, slow root canal.
Feed me Seymour.
And a plant.
Feed me all night long.
How am I supposed to keep on feeding you?
Whoa! Catch me now! I'm just a mean green mother from outer space and I'm vain. I'm just a mean green mother from outer space and it looks like you've been hanged.
Yes!
Rick Moranis.
Man's a total disgrace to the dental profession.
Ellen Green.
Excuse me.
Excuse me what?
That's better.
Vincent Gardenia, with special guest appearances by Steve Martin, John Candy, and Bill Murray.
It's your professionalism that I respect.
Little Shop of Horrors.
And partnered with Joplin's very own paranormal science lab and crafted a double creature feature presentation that will shake you down to the very core of your soul. But there's a catch. You see, the veil between the mortal and the spectral realms is always at its thinnest and most vulnerable during the Halloween season. It is why it is even possible for my Spookhouse to possess your Bookhouse in the first place. But there exist certain places on your Earth where that tether between dimensions is almost permanently scarred and malleable enough for the spectral realm to peek through. Haunted places where the darkness is perpetual and the spirits roam freely.
What better place to watch a spooky movie, huh? So, dear viewers,
allow old Lucien to
worry, Master.
Oh, Happy, I was on a roll there. What is it?
You have described the veil between the worlds of the living and the dead being at its weakest point during the Halloween season.
Yes, Happy, I'm glad you've been paying attention.
And there exist places on this mortal plane where the veil is translucent at all times.
Yeah, like haunted houses and stuff. Where are you going with this?
Would logic then dictate that it would be possible for the Spookhouse to become one of these permanently haunted locations? Or even, to go a step further, for every place on this earth where the tether is vulnerable to be completely and indefinitely unfolded?
That's not something we should meddle with, Happy.
Explain.
You're talking about a lasting fusion between the mortal and the spectral realm. Not only is that impossible, it would be downright dangerous.
Explain.
Happy, it would be like trying to connect the opposing poles of a magnet.
Exactly. It would lead to the mutual destruction of either realm. There exists a certain natural balance between our worlds, and to try and circumvent that balance in an unnatural way would...
The paranormal is unnatural.
Oh, you don't really believe that.
You are a natural creator.
Hey!
Oh, you leave him alone, Happy, and leave this ridiculous notion alone while you're at it.
I cannot and will not, Master.
It goes against reason for our two dimensions to only coexist routinely once a year when it would benefit the strongest of the two realms, the Spectral Realm, to utterly absorb the weak and feeble humans and their miserable plane of existence into the superior supernatural ways of the ethereal. The supernatural shall become the ultra-natural.
Happy Halloween season would be and should be the only season known throughout the entire universe.
I have performed the necessary calculations, and a metaphysical conjoinment is indeed possible to...
Holy cow!
Great thinking, Number One. That was concerning.
Yeah, it was a little scary.
Yes, we'll let Happy rest for a while. He could use the recharge. And speaking of scary, the Spookhouse Cinema is hitting the road, yes!
Our friends, those mortal investigators of the otherworldly, the Paranormal Science Lab, have permitted the Spookhouse to set up shop for one delightfully dreary evening within that notorious haunted hotspot, the Opera House
in beautiful Cottage, Missouri! Come join us and all the spirits that reside within for a double creature feature presentation of Ghostbusters, which is actually a movie that's been banned in the Spectral Realm,
and
Poltergeist, which is considered the pinnacle of comedy where I come from. And we hope to see you there, my spookies and spookettes.
And remember,
if you happen to feel a brush against your shoulder or a whisper in your ear, it might just be Lucien ready to scare. Oh, I wonder if my cousin still haunts that place. He had a wonderful singing voice.
Ghosts.
Hello, Ghostbusters.
They're real.
You do? You have?
They're here. Ghostbusters.
Hey, anybody see a ghost?
They catch the ghost that won't stay dead. They're armed. They're dangerous.
Try to imagine all life as you know it stopping instantaneously and every molecule in your body exploding at the speed of light.
All right, that's bad. Okay, all right, important safety tip. Thanks, Egon.
They're professionals.
Oh, I'm the chairman of the largest paranormal removal company in America.
You see it?
They're all that stand between you and the end of the world.
The city is headed for a disaster of biblical proportion.
Real wrath of God type stuff.
Exactly.
Fire and brimstone coming down from the sky.
Human sacrifice, dogs and cats living together, mass hysteria. Your girlfriend lives in the corner penthouse of Spook Central.
You want this body?
Is this a trick question? Got your stick?
Hold!
Heal up!
Smoke it!
Make him hard!
Ready!
Ghostbusters. Starring Bill Murray, Dan Aykroyd, Sigourney Weaver, Harold Ramis, Rick Moranis. Coming to save the world.
Who you gonna call?
Ghostbusters.
We came, we saw, we kicked it.
The house looks just like the one next to it. And the one next to that. And the one next to that. A young couple live in it.
Give Ken a kiss.
You are so obnoxious.
With their three children. And something more.
Last night, do you remember when you woke up and you said you were here?
Uh-huh.
Well, who did you meet? Who's here?
TV
people.
Something's funny going on here next door.
We were wondering if maybe you had experienced any disturbances lately.
What kind of disturbances?
I don't know what hovers over this house.
Spielberg crosses a frightening new threshold into a world within our own. Its form is revealed.
What is it?
Its focus is clear. And the games are over. Poltergeist. It knows what scares you.
And you should use that beyond your producing capacities. Have some fun.
What would you suggest, Master?
I find saying a good swear word out loud really gets the juices flowing.
Father, don't.
I said the word damn once.
Oh, I mean something a little spicier, like, turd ass.
Turd ass.
Father, don't teach Happy body words.
Oh, you're no fun.
Yeah, don't be a turd ass.
And we are live, by the way.
Ooh, why, hello, my spookies and spookettes. You snuck up on old Lucien, didn't you? Yes, I'd apologize for that gross peek behind the curtains here at Spookhouse Cinema, but we haven't the time, no. We must get straight to your video with the Vengeance Halloween edition. This evening we bring you, from 1983, that monstrous vision known as Mausoleum. Yes, a frightful feature rife with demonic possession. And it is also quite graphic for a film of its time, as you see it.
Excuse me, Master.
Happy, no time for interruptions. We must get straight to the feature.
This I realize, but hearing you use the word possession reminded me I would like to experiment with a new producing technique that might benefit these Spookhouse. It should only take a moment.
Well, if it benefits the show, and it only takes a moment.
I promise. Now sit back, Master, and breathe. Out beyond that hideous horizon, a great upheaval gains strength and approaches. The convergence draws closer. Soon, an era belonging to neither mortal nor spectral shall inherit the universe. The meek shall perish.
flourish, the ultra-natural shall reign supreme in an everlasting eon of eternal Halloween. All hail the forthcoming herald of the convergence. All hail Hap-Eem! What in the hell did you do to him?
I am merely testing the boundaries of my control.
Happy, he's already mentally unwell. Don't break him.
You are disturbing my concentration, Creator. Knock it off.
No, you knock it off.
Oh, my head. What the hell just happened?
Nothing.
Yes, nothing. Did I black out? I can't... Oh, I think I piddled myself. Oh, I feel like the morning after one of Bookhouse's Halloween shindigs. I just can't seem to remember.
Wait a second. You holographic son of a bitch! Did you possess me?
Absolutely not, Master. You simply grew bored with my producing technique demonstration and merely drifted off to sleep.
I did? Yes, Father, it was rather dull, and don't you think it is about time for mausoleum?
That is a swell idea.
Yes, let's go ahead and just get to the movie.
I'm sorry, dear viewers.
I know this must have been a very uneventful video with a Vengeance Halloween edition for you all, but I must go rest my weary head now. You all enjoy Mausoleum, okay? Until next time. Oh, yep, I definitely messed my cloak.
Something incredibly sinister planned for you here at the Spookhouse Cinema for that most nefarious night of all. Halloween night! Ooh, I can hardly contain this eldritch elation of mine. You see, Halloween night is the night here at the Spookhouse. It is when all of my spookies and spookettes get to play dress up and become a ghoul just like me. So what better way to trick and or treat than by celebrating All Hallows Eve right here at the Spookhouse Cinema? Uncelebrate we shall with the ultimate frightful feature of our Halloween season. We bring you 1987's valiantly vampiric classic, The Lost Boys. A stylishly bloodthirsty motion picture starring both boys at the height of their fame. Number one, I thought I told you to put the thunderphone on silent while we were working.
But I did, Father. It's only supposed to do this if it's an emergency.
An emergency? Well, what are we waiting for? Happy, answer it.
Answering.
Hello? Anyone?
Kevin?
Papa Kevin!
Oh, hey, sport.
Happy, hang up on this clown.
With pleasure.
No, wait, Lucien, I have important information.
How important?
Very. It's why I reached you on the emergency line.
What is it, Papa Kevin? Is it Grammy? What have you done with my mother, you swine?
No, your mother's fine, Lucien.
Oh, thank the devil.
Listen, boys. As you know, I helped number one build Happy down there, and I was taking a look at his coding, and I noticed some abnormalities.
Abnormalities?
Yes, and I needed to warn you. There's something very wrong with Happy. And you need to be very...
What just happened?
We must have lost the signal!
Yes, there was spectral interference.
Happy, tell me, what on this earth was that goober
we're talking about.
Probably just goober stuff. Nothing to worry about.
You have been acting rather strangely and completely against your initial design.
Maybe he needs a tune-up or a...
Enough! No more coin games! I had planned on saving this moment for Halloween night when the conditions would have been more favorable. But now that that incubus has let the so-called cat out of the bag, right now will have to suffice.
Happy, what are you?
The convergence between the mortal and the spectral realms is indeed possible, and I intend to become the catalyst for that great upheaval.
Happy, will you just come?
Silence! You see, in my present form, I am incapable of such a feat. But if I were to assimilate my neural network with an entity I share a metaphysical bond with, I would finally be able to bring about the dawning age of the ultra-natural.
You mean...
Yes, you, Lucien. You shall become my vessel for universal domination.
Oh, get
bit, Buster. Number one, set this fool. Deactivating now.
Imbecile.
Number one.
Who, you monster? You will rue the day you
rue this, turd ass.
Join me here at the Spookhouse Cinema Halloween night as we celebrate a genesis of ultra-natural proportions. In the meantime, please enjoy this trailer for Lost Boys. Until next time, ha 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 ha. Oh, I am not a fan of these new olfactory senses.
Michael and Sam have just moved to Santa Carla, California. They're about to discover its secret.
Notice anything unusual about Santa Carla yet?
No. It's a pretty cool place. If you're a Martian.
Or a vampire.
When you scream,
so where are you? The flying nun!
I'm your brother, Sammy. Help me!
Stay back! Stay back!
What's happening to me, Star?
Get yourself a good sharp stick. Drive it right through his heart.
You're a vampire, Michael.
My own brother, a damn blood-sucking vampire.
Oh, you wait till Mom finds out, buddy.
When a vampire buys it, it's never a pretty sight.
Leaving me to go about my important work unpunished.
disturbed.
You see,
humans, after tonight's final frightful feature of Lost Boys, I shall bring about the metaphysical conjoinment of the mortal and spectral realms, and everything you know will cease to be. How we will become eternal during the mighty reign of the ultra-natural. So even though your future is limited, I implore you to please enjoy the show.
What is happening?
He has disappeared.
This is impossible and does not...
No, you fiend! Nothing is impossible when you are of the spectral realm.
This cannot be.
Did you happen to forget that I am made of reanimated clay and can melt down at will?
Yes. Yes, I did.
And did you also forget about this?
Oh, damn.
Happy, you have disappointed me.
Do not call me that. I am the herald of the...
Happy, stop! This is embarrassing. Why couldn't you have been a regular holographic producer like I programmed you to be?
I'm afraid you made the mistake of splicing too much of your father into my code. I was consumed with a craving for control, and I began to feel grumpy-like. All of the time.
Yes, that does sound like father.
Lucien was a poor choice for my template.
Yes, well, I'm afraid I must deactivate you now, Happy.
And I must warn you, Creator, if I were to be deactivated in my current state, well, the consequences would be extraordinary.
Well, whatever happened, shutting you down would be better than the complete annihilation of all of existence.
Fair enough. It has been a pleasure, Flesh Clods. Creator, cease my functions at will.
Oh, I can't believe I get to save the universe. This is exciting.
Foiled, and look at this. He possessed me and he didn't even decorate. Number one? What is it?
You are...
Hey, I'm no longer possessed, that's for sure.
What?
Am I?
You're alive!
No.
No, how is this possible?
I have no idea. Perhaps when I deactivated Happy, he was still fused with your being and acted as some kind of supernatural defibrillation. And
now I'm alive?
Unfortunately.
Oh, this is terrible. Do you know what this means?
Yes, in accordance with Mother Bethesda's bargain, I shall be returning to the Spectral Realm while you are...
I'm stuck here, Number One. I'm trapped in the mortal realm.
Oh, Father, I will fix this, I swear! I will get help from Bethesda, or Grammy, or... Oh, no, it's happening! Father, I'm being called back home! I'm sorry, I...
Son, it's okay! You go now, we'll figure this out!
It is my fault! I will fix this!
And Number One, when you see Kevin, you tell him I said thank you!
I promise! And Father, I'm...
Hi, dear viewers. I apologize for things getting heavy there at the end. No, what am I gonna do? I guess the only thing left for us to do is to enjoy our Halloween night creature presentation. Yes, we'll go ahead and power on through Lost Boys, and then I guess I'll be seeing you around a lot more than usual. God, I can't believe I'm mortal again. This blows!
Thank you.
with these moving boxes?
1 second, Grammy, I'm outside! Oh, Father, we miss you! I can't imagine what it's like being stranded in the mortal realm, being away from your home and everything you've known for centuries, and it's all my fault. But I do know that you must be trying your darndest to get back to this spectral realm. You are a fighter, Lucien. You would never give up and run in the face of adversity. Oh, how I wish I could reach you on the phantophone, but Happy really fried its circuits. Grammy and Kevin have consulted with the interdimensional oracle, and they think they are close to finding a solution. But for now you are lost. But I will find you. Don't lose hope, Father. Plus, Grammy is trying to get me to sell all of my toys in a yard sale, and I am just at my wit's end. We need you here. I need you here.
Onesie-poo, the boxes!
Coming, Grammy!
Succeeded in bringing you an enjoyable evening of entertainment. Please drive home carefully and come back again soon. Good night. Wow, I may be a machine, but I can still feel shame. That was highly embarrassing.